Members of FDC Katonga faction today submitted a request to reserve a new political party name, colors, symbol and slogan which will dissociate them from the FDC Najanankumbi. With the fawn as a party symbol and white and royal blue as their colors, the proposed party will carry the name People's Front for Freedom. The slogan is Freedom for all for freedom. Leading a group of 12 to the Electoral Commission offices was the party chairperson for Gago District, Kenneth Opoha.
We have come today to preserve the names of a political party which we believe is going to liberate this country. And I want to take this moment. I know the Electoral Commission, they have not yet done their part, but we have already submitted the name of a new political vehicle that can transform this nation. Is People Front for Freedom.
So this is the time we have started the new party. We are a representative of the whole country. We are 12 promoters. We are here. We are going to traverse all this country. I am a national mobilizer by experience, and I will be reaching every part of the country to make sure that especially we withdraw the cards, the materials that we had given them previously for the mobilization I've done in the last 20 and plus years.
Others included Wafula Ogutu, lawyer Wanda Ronald and Ingrid Rinawe. Julius Muchunguzi, the Electoral Commission spokesperson, confirmed receipt of the application.
Yes, it is true. We have today received a group that has come to reserve a name. And symbols as part of the process for registering a political party organization.
The grand finale for the National Debate Championship will be held at Makere University tomorrow. Today, 30 teams gathered at Kololo Secondary School, and the best two teams were selected for tomorrow's finals. Among the qualities sought by the adjudicators are arguments, evidence, presentation, explanation, and speaker points.
Filled up with great sorrow of how my people are born to unlasting and forever suffering. They are born to flooding and they are born to famine. Look at the situation whereby my people are not looking at the forthcoming dangers to themselves.
John Eremo, the Green Schools Initiative project manager, said the project track focuses on climate change innovation at schools and community levels, while the second involves debates at regional and national levels. The Green Schools Initiative was launched in 2022 with 100 secondary schools across 10 regions. Last year's championship was won by Sacred Heart Secondary School Muhanga from Shima, who bagged 12 million shillings. The campaign is supported by the Swedish Embassy and the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations.
Onwards to this, we give you the impact of both affirmative and neg case, and we weighed and showed you exactly why we believe that evicting these people and not giving them adequate compensation, but rather giving them better social service delivery, what made them move in the first place, will then solve the root cause, ensure that these people do not move to any other biodiversity hotspot, national parks, reserves, or other wetlands.
Six suspects battling cases of causing the government a financial loss of 3.8 billion shillings meant for the Bukaya Growers Cooperative today appeared before Justice Jane Okwo. All the accused denied charges on all the nine counts read out to them. Among the accused are Trade Ministry Permanent Secretary Geraldine Tbusura Sali, Leonard Kavundira, the Principal Cooperative Officer at the Trade Ministry, and lawyer Julius Kiria. Others are legislators Michael Mawanda Muranga of Igara East, Ignatius Wamakuyu Mudimi of Elgon County, and Paul Akamba of Busiki County. Among the charges levied upon them are stealing by an agent, money laundering, causing financial loss to the government, and abuse of office.
My Lord, bail is applied at any given stage of the case, regardless of whether the case has been fixed for trial or not.
Justice Oko directed the prosecution to expedite investigations before adjourning the case to October 23rd. The court also heard the bail application for Mawanda, Akamba and Kiriam.
These three people whom the law presumes innocent have come before you today. And they are requesting that you exercise your discretion by releasing them on bail.
We disputed all the sureties and their particulars that were attached.
Whereas all the securities were presented before the court, the prosecution led by Edward Muhumuza objected to it. The judge then set 30th August for a ruling on bail.